revolution and counter-revolution. After just a year in power, the Muslim Brotherhood is ousted in a military coup. Protesters are shot. Rioters take their revenge on Egypt's Christian minority, burning scores of churches, homes and businesses. Then military strongman Abdel Fattah al-Sisi is swept to power. He's the first Egyptian president ever to attend Christmas Mass. Standing shoulder to shoulder with the Coptic Pope, this Muslim president declares, "We are Egyptians." At the seat of Islamic learning, Al-Azhar University, al-Sisi calls for Islam to break free from extremism. So could change finally be in store for Egypt's Christians? Anzaki is a professor at Cairo's Evangelical Theological Seminary.
The fact that we have a constitution that articulates the rights of Christians and minorities is already a great sign of hope for us. So when we see the government being more willing in giving licenses for new church buildings, when we see the doors of the president's office open to clergy, to the Christian Pope, we see signs of a government that's willing to recognize us as full citizens of this nation. Not only do the Christians have the right and the freedom to worship, but they will be backed up by the military and they will be backed up by the government.
Pastor Maru's church in Saniem village was one of scores targeted by protesters, along with police stations, courts, and other symbols of authority. Among the attackers were their neighbors, who set the church on fire and then tried to lure the family of four into the flames. "We got up and we were very frightened," says Pastor Maruz. "And I looked from the window and I saw them coming towards the church door. They were throwing Molotov bombs towards the walls of the church. And I asked them, 'Why are you doing this? We're brothers and we're living together and we love you.' They said, 'We are not brothers.'" Pastor Maruz, his wife Nadia and their two young children have had trauma counseling. "God gave us forgiveness for those people," he says, "and he raised us up again to do his work." Despite their poverty, they pooled what little they had to pay for their church to be restored. "We became like one man and worked," says Pastor Maruz, "and God was with us and gave us success. It felt like a reward, a heavenly reward." Today, he says, the congregation is growing and is stronger than before. 300 attend each Sunday. The church even runs a food bank and supports its Muslim neighbors. The women's prayer meeting is led by Mariam. "After the attack," she says, "we couldn't walk the streets. We were so afraid that we were crying. But we had faith in God that he would take care of us. Right now, we can see the hand of God controlling everything. We're so happy." Release is encouraging Egypt to give full equal rights to Christians, not just in theory, but in practice.